Johnstone has landed, 104.5. From Stewart Air Force Base, in Newburgh, New York, rehearsing for his upcoming tour. Doing performance with some special friends. Ending conversation with Gene Becker. Tonight, the news that brings you the return of Nico. For an upcoming world tour, supporting his new album, Dead Ringer, which is already number one in the charts in Britain and moving fast here in North America. For the rehearsals, he rented a vacant aircraft hangar at Stewart Air Force Base, a top security facility only 2 hours out of downtown Manhattan, and one of the only places he could bring in the immense amount of sound and lighting equipment he and his crew of 37 people needed to work with for 3 solid weeks. It's been 3 years since his last tour, and on this one, Meatloaf's taking no chances. He's going over the best technical tools available, using some weird and wonderful effects. There was a family atmosphere among everybody involved in the project, even though they were working up to 14 hours a day. But it was the kind of work that's necessary to get the stage show to the level of fans who demand, and give Meatloaf the kind of success he enjoyed with the album Battered as Hell, and songs like Paradise or the Dashboard Light. Success of Battered as Hell, which was the second biggest selling debut album in Canada, Meatloaf has been lying low. Gene asked him how he felt about his comeback.
I was wondering what a comeback was. That's like, I was reading, I don't know if people know who Jim Plunkett is. Jim Plunkett was the quarterback for the Oakland Raiders last year. And he was going, I never came, I don't know what a comeback is. I was just sitting on the bench for a little while. I didn't really come back. I could always do what I could always do. It just so happens that then all of a sudden here I am doing it again. It's not really a comeback.
But it did take a long time to...
You know,
get together to do it again.
Yeah,
what the rumors going around about you?
Well, the voice just decided to take a rest. And I'm still working on it to come back 100%, you know. It's not, but it's close.
But it's back.
No, I don't. I don't, but it's back enough that it's all I need.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
I heard you got a great therapist.
Yeah, he's unbelievable. The voice has days, you know. It's just not... What's missing is the strength in it. In other words, the endurance. And that just comes with time.
For this upcoming tour, Meatloaf has surrounded himself with an incredible collection of musicians. Terry Williams, one of the world's great rock drummers, who is available because rock pile fell apart. Davey Johnstone, who for years played with Elton John, toured with Dallas Cooper, and only recently finished work with Stevie Nicks on her Belladonna album. Other members include Steve Buslowe, who toured with Neeley on his first tour, Paul Jacobs, who replaces Jim Steinman on keyboards, George Myers on second keyboards, backup singer Teddy Neeley, once the lead of the musical Jesus Christ Superstar, and Eric Troyer, also on backup vocals. Meatloaf's biggest problem was replacing Carlo DeVito, his touring partner for Battered as Hell, and now a star in her own right. His choice was Pamela Moore, who came to these auditions following a successful tour backing up Bob Seger.
You know, immediately going out, she's going to be in trouble because they're going to compare her to Carlo DeVito. And the problem is that people only remember the end of Carlo DeVito and what she did at the end. They don't remember how she started. Carlo started, it takes a while to get into performance. Carlo, at this point in time, meaning what Pam is, was in exactly the same position as Pam. Because it's real hard to figure out what I got going on in my mind. And I see Pamela in the back, like, going crazy, going over the head. She came apart, she stands still, and I told her, okay, she's going to stand still. I told her, move in the back, stand still in the front. I'm going to stand still, so I'm going to stand still in the back.
Shelter, send the ball up on the first part of the show to pick up James Shelter.
without Jim Steinman's material?
See, that's the question. You know, I would have been successful because I am a live performer, and I would have succeeded to a wide extent. Without those songs, no, that would have not sold as many records. Period. Because each added to the other. Without me touring that, I would have sold 300,000. With me touring that, sold about 8 million. But one plays the other. If they had me seen me do Paradise and those songs, there were maybe 2 million. You know, maybe none. I don't know.
Through watching the crew work out for a week in preparation for tour, one thing became clearly evident. Nico is a tyrant. And when it comes to making decisions, this ain't no democracy.
It's a very tough tour.
You're pretty tough dealing with the band
and ordering
people around, but you said that your bars was worse than your
bite. I say please and thank you. I'm polite.
You're not a dictator.
I am, but I'm polite about it. I'm a very polite dictator.
Is competitive, likes to run the show, even when it comes down to a quick break for football. If you see any other reason for a 300-pound quarterback? Meatloaf was vulnerable only once during these rehearsals, when they were testing a voice used to climb him out of the band through a grand entrance. The whole band was planned to leave him hungry and being frustrated. Every time his feet touched the ground and thought it was all over, they hauled Meat back up again.
This older woman forever, and she must be at least 19, he must be at least 16, you know? She's got a car, she's got one, and finally, he gets the nerve up to go make his move, and she scares him half to death and backs him into a corner, and winds up taking him home anyway, but it's very unrealistic. I mean, you don't have to be 16 or 19, you don't have to be an older woman, that was just my description at the moment. In a middle section, I used African logs and jumping birds and everything. So I figured that what takes place in those in these single bars or in bars, it's very basic. It's a very basic position. You know, it's like your place and mine. My manager's this year. That's a tempo. Now, I don't think she's right for the part. We can pull the evidence. She is right for the part. Amazing to be. You know, that's a guess. She would have a great concert. But I don't know. It's a song kind of hard to sing. You know, it's in a weird key for our people. And then they said, well, bring that. I said, well, I'm not going to go in and tell this star, this woman, who is, you know, all real talent and everything. She's not good enough for my song. I feel like an idiot. And they said, well, we'll be there to do it. She came and they did. But luckily, she walked in within 2 minutes of leaving the studio. We were working together great. And then, through the film, I knew that, you know, she was a natural. She understood the song right away. A lot of people didn't, you know, the dramatic and the chance, and da 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 da, you know, it goes on. And, so she brought in her dancers. I brought in my softball team. And that's what I could do with that record.
What about your appeal when you've been considered sex symbol for
fashion? Absolutely.
Has married life changed any of that?
No, I still have my charm.
What do you think the secret is?
Hey, I'm from Texas. My secret with women is that I actually understand women. I don't understand men at all. In an argument between a man and a woman, I would always side with the woman. I think most men are jerks.
Good, I'm glad you said that. Listen, thanks a lot, Neeley. It was great talking to you.
Yeah, now I'm going to get stoned by all the men.
Oh, yeah. Great. Okay.
Not all the men are jerks, but you know, they have certain attitudes. They ought to think about, you know, changing it around a bit. You know what I mean? Okay. Bye.